I wake up in the morning and I crawl out of bed and I feel just like the living dead. It's time to start another day, and as usual, I'm running late. So my mind starts going 100 miles an hour. Don't even have time enough to take a shower. When I get in my car, it feels like I'm barely alive. 10 minutes later, I arrive at my stupid day job. Stupid day job. My stupid day job. Well, I drink 3 cups of coffee for that extra kick, but I still feel crappy, I should've called in sick. My boss isn't late for a meeting at 10. Looks like I'll be written up again. Oh well, it's just another day. Another dollar, another nail in the coffin, another reason to feel smaller. Sometimes I wish I could just drive off far away, but my lack of financial security means I'll have to stay at my stupid day job. Stupid day job. My stupid day job. Now I think it's time everyone with a stupid day job unite against the forces that try to control us. Yes, every paper cut written file clerk, every greasy smelling burger flipper, every short change in cashier, it's time to unite. I'll start a stupid day jobs union, and we can go on strike outside every retail establishment and fast food hellhole in the world. Fight the power. And our platform will stand for dignity, higher wages, and no more polyester uniforms. And I could be the spokesman for the underemployed, yeah. I'll be like the Jimmy Hoffa of the janitors or the Gandhi of the gas station attendants. But some people won't agree with my ideas, so they'll kill me. And then I could be a martyr for the stupid day jobs movement. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool, I think. Now, I wrote all that stuff about the stupid day jobs union while I was on my lunch break. But I couldn't write anymore because I had to get back to work. So let's just pretend that I ended that part of the story with lyrics that were so inspiring that they changed all your lives forever. Are you done pretending? Okay. Now it's after lunch, and I'm making copies while daydreaming about my vacation. I see myself lounging on the beach in an exotic location. Suddenly my tie gets caught in the copy machine, right in the middle of duplications. And as I lie there choking to death, all I can think about is workman's compensation. But then the office manager comes by, cuts my tie, saving me from suffocation. He looks at me like I'm a jerk and says, "Get back to work." And I feel so much frustration at my stupid day job. Stupid day job. My stupid day job. Well, I'm working for my family and I'm working for God. I'm working so people won't say I'm a lazy slob. I'm working to put food on the table, and I'm working so I can say look for that union label. I'm working so I can buy stuff that I don't need, and I'm working cause nobody will pay me to watch TV. Now basically I feel so traumatized about my stupid day job that I'm gonna try to start singing like Morrissey now. Stupid day job, stupid day job, stupid day job, stupid day job. Ah, stupid day job.
Sucks to be a tortured artist.